shoulder width apart, and you'll also need about this much space. So, that much space. Great. Okay, have the hips sinking back and down. And just very gently breathe in and breathe out. Oh, lovely. So relax the shoulders. Breathe in and breathe out. Relax around the jaw. Just allow your muscles to soften. And you want to feel that your feet, you want to get the get yourself in the first two thirds of the feet, and then what you do is you sink your hips back and down so that you allow yourself to go through the balance point of the foot, which is just behind the ball of each foot. We're going to have a look at balance today. We're just breathing, and so just allow the muscles around the arms to soften and relax, the chin to tuck in a bit, and we're just going to turn the waist, just nice and relaxed. So remember, we've got this week, next week, and then the week after I'm doing my final assessment thing in Birmingham for the Tai Chi for rehabilitation. So there won't be class, unfortunately. And then I just want to know what people's views are, because technically our last class of term is the 19th of December, but that might be a bit close to Christmas, or if you let me know if you think you might be here, then I'm very happy to come and do it. I'm definitely not teaching the evening class that day, but I'm happy to teach the morning class if enough people are interested in coming along to it. So if anyone's too cold, you can turn up the radiators a bit and that will warm us all up. So let's just breathe in and out. So relax around the shoulders. So you just want to allow your arms to be moved by what you're doing in your waist. And you also want your knees in line with the toes. So the knees are in line with the toes. You're all breathing. So feel the breath as it goes in, feel the breath as it comes out. Around the jaw. Keep breathing, very nice. Okay, and then very gently, just slowly raise the arms up to about chest height. Keep breathing some more. Just let the arms relax. Okay, check your posture. So the first two thirds of the foot. So put yourself in the first two thirds of the foot, sink the hips back and down. And then we just float up. So the head floats, the hips sink back and down. And the sinking of the hips is what brings up your head. And let the muscles soften. And then what we're going to do, we're just going to transfer the weight. So get your weight to settle in the ball, just behind the ball of each foot. And we're just transferring the weight from one side to the other. So you just want to feel the weight going to the, that's it. I'm going to keep the hips and knees and shoulders in line. And relax the arms. Breathe in and out. Great. And really feel the contact through the feet. Chin tucked in, nice and relaxed in the body. Keep breathing. Morning.
Hi.
No worries. We actually started about a bit later. You've not missed much. Yeah, it's quite hot, you know, this time of year when it's sort of wet and horrible and cold and ugh, it's fine. And we're all breathing. Right. Yeah. So you just notice the sensation of contact through the feet and how it changes. And again, you want to softly gaze forward. So if I show you that from the side, I'm looking eye level. Forward gaze. Hiya.
Hi.
Welcome. Okay. Just find some space. So I'll just start us off again. So we were in the first two thirds of the foot, and then you sink the hips back and down. And then you nice and relax, and then we're just transferring the weight through one foot, transferring the weight through the other. So you want your arms relaxed, you want your chin tucked in slightly, and really pay attention and listen to that foot. Fantastic. Okay, come back to the middle again. Just allow yourself to settle just behind the ball of each foot, and we're going to go forwards and back. Mm-hmm. Just breathe naturally. Just notice the breath as it comes in. Notice the breath as it comes out. That's it. Nice and relaxed. So. Keep breathing some more. I'll show you that from the diagonal view. So I'm going forward and back, not too far forward and not too far back. So, and then when I go forward, what I do is I push with my toes, sinking the heels. So you're using the toes to kind of push yourself forward and back. Allow yourself to settle just behind the ball of each foot, and then what we're going to do is we're going to go round and round. So you're feeling the outside edge of the foot, the outside edge. Again, you want to sink your hips back and down. You want soft knees. You're breathing, relaxing around the jaw, that's it. Keep breathing some more. So notice the breath as it comes in, notice the breath as it comes out. Fantastic. Okay, let's go round in the other direction. So, pay attention to the sensation of contact through the feet. Do a bit of bounce, so let's do bounce and then we'll also do shake. So you want to just feel your whole body is connected and you want to let go in the lower back. So let go in the lower back, lengthen through the head, softly gazing forward as you listen behind and above. Very good. And we're all breathing. So that bounce, and then we've got 4, 3, 2, 1, shake. So feel that your whole of your body is connected. You want to just try. Keep breathing, very nice. 4, 3, 2, one, back to bounce, that's better. And then we just do this one. So nice open feeling in the arms. You want to relax the shoulders. Relax the shoulders. And see if you can, just for today, just extending through the fingertips. So see if you can just feel kind of firmness in the fingertips. I'll show you that from the side. That's it, and we're all nice and tall. And breathing. Very good. Down and up, down and up, down and up, down and up, down and up. So use your hips to move the arms. So you drop. That's it. And shake from the back. And you wanna relax. So calm the mind, soften the muscles. Calm the mind and soften the muscles, very good. And the reason why the arms go up is because they drop. They drop down, and that's what brings them up. Okay, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then we change by turning the palms and pivoting around the elbow. There we go. So it is a bit cold today, so I want to make sure we've got very content and happy joints, if that's all right. And then we'll have a look. It was a whole week ago. I can't remember what we'd agreed to do this week. Can anyone remember? No? No? Okay. I think we'd been looking at the Fasun Gong, hadn't we? And silk reading. And then I was hoping, I think, to move on to possibly the second or 18 set as our warm up, because that's quite fun. But we'll have a look. 4, 3, 2, and 1, and then one in front, one behind. So you transfer the weight and turn, transfer the weight and turn. That's it. And you just want to. We'll have a look at this in more detail at some other point, but let's just. So you transfer the weight and turn, transfer the weight and turn. So you want to go to the. Actually, have a shake out. Let's have a look at more detail right now. Let's just check anyway. I think the clock has stopped. The clock has stopped, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's 5:02.
What is the actual time?
Okay, what I'll do. Ah! That makes sense. Okay. That makes a lot more sense now. What's that? Oh, I am on. Hang on. So we'll want a tea break at 15:15, won't we?
Right.
Okay. I'll put the time on. Hang on, so that's
everything stops for tea.
Everything stops for tea.
That's very important. But we won't have as long. The problem is last week we had this really huge tea break and then we didn't get enough time to do things in. So, and you know, I mean, it is nice, but so we'll have to try and balance the requirement for tea with the requirement for exercise. I think that's very, you know, it's good to get a balance. So anyway, talking of which, loosening exercise number one. So this was the first of the loosening exercises I learned off Master Chun many, many years ago now. I'm not even sure if he's still in practice, but he was very, very good. Gold medalist, Tai Chi, produced gold medalist people, used Tai Chi to help fix a heart issue he had. So he developed a heart issue when he was in his early 20s, which isn't when you want to do things like that. And then in Malaysia, where he lived, a Malaysian Chinese guy, he got sent to a master herbalist and a master Tai Chi master. And then that's what he did. So he fixed, and then he got very got his health back, and then got so into Tai Chi, he was just going to do it till his heart was okay. But then he liked it so much that he became a master himself. And then when he moved to this country, so this was one of the exercises I learned from him. So how this works, I'll just show you from slow motion. So there's the sinking and raising of the hips. And you also want to make sure you're aligned. You want to make sure you're correctly aligned. So the idea is it's like you're sitting on a high stool and you sink, the hips go back and down. And when I did standing with Master Chun, we'd do some standing exercises. He'd call it, "I'm going to do some sitting now," and then we'd be standing up doing this. But it was, you know, like I knew very hardly any Chinese at all, so it was fine. And you want to like that. And then what happens is you come like this, and this is it in slow motion. You transfer the weight. And then what I'm doing is I'm using the corners, the top front corners, as a reference, as like an orientation thing. And then one goes in front and one goes behind. And you want to stay upright. So you actually physically, when I did it with Master Chun, he actually had the whole of the forearm in front there, and the whole of the, and that in the back. And I'm looking, and then you come back to the middle, so you raise, so the arms drop, and because they just allow them to drop, one comes up the front, one comes around the back. So you just drop and they fold. So they drop and fold, and then there's a weight shift. So if we do it in slow-mo, and then we'll do it faster, but you want to be very relaxed in your body. So really feel that these muscles here, the muscles on the upper trapezius, muscles are sinking and softening, and there's this corresponding upward feeling in your supporting bones. So think of your supporting bones as coming up and your muscles as hanging down. And then you want to calm the mind. And then use these exercises as a way of practicing your focus of attention. So so we come up, transfer, one in front, one behind, transfer, one in front, one behind. Use your breathing, so soften, that's better. So you wanna drop the arms and they fold. You come up, they come up naturally, drop the arms and they fold. And you want to keep yourself upright. So you're moving efficiently and we're all breathing. quicker. So this is what we were doing earlier. So let the arms go. So the arms, that's handy. I've got my useful jumper, right. So we've got a jumper here, and if I cut a knot, I must remember to unknot the sleeve at the end, so if it gets cold, I can get my hand through. But look, if you've got a, look, that's what the arms are like. They want to be really passive. So, they want to be passive. So when you want to get all, there's definite shape and structure to the arms, but you want to get rid of the muscle tension in the arms. So if we just look, if you just do that, see, that's being moved. That's being moved by your body. And then try that the other side. See, and then it just kind of, you're not having to do anything with the arms. So when you do it with this, look. One in front, one behind. I'll show you that from the back, so you can see it from the back. So I'm maintaining my structural integrity. And I'm breathing. Oh. So, and it comes up, that angle. So maintain your focus and tension. And that's better, isn't it? Yeah. 4, 3, 2. Okay, just let the arms go. Check the posture again. First two thirds. Sink the hips. Soften the muscles. Calm the mind. Focus on the breathing. Feel that the spine is nice and upright. Notice the contact with the ground. And then, there we go. So you can do it without the hands touching, or you can put one hand on the top and give it an extra little push. It's the way he did that. And then there's this bounce thing going through the legs. Now, not all teachers teach it this way. You just want to let the arms go. Let the arms drop more. Not all. Teachers teach this, so you'll get one teacher go, oh no, we don't do the bounce at all, that's all wrong. But it kind of, basically they're all correct, so whoever's at front, that's what you do. And then whatever you've done before just goes out of your head, and you just try and do what's going there, because it's the idea of it is practicing your focus of attention in the here and now. So if you had a teacher that said, no, it's like this, they're completely correct. But we're doing it like this at this present moment. So it's that kind of thing. Took me a while to work that one out, and I used to get kind of frustrated because, Oh, that's better, isn't it? So just let the arms really drop. So right to the, so you're just dropping them. That's a gravity thing. Just letting gravity do its thing. 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're nice and tall. So check your posture again, and then we're turning the waist, and just let the arms, very small movement. So I went to a couple of Mike's classes last week, and he's been working on doing not a lot. And so you want to really let go in the shoulder here, in the shoulder joint, and lengthen the arms, and just keeping the arms long and not moving too much. And we will breathe. That's it. So we just feel the waist turn. So that's this area here. That's turning, and there's still that little bit of a bounce. 4, 3, 2, 1, and change. been watching Grandmaster Chen Xiaorang videos on YouTube quite a bit, and yeah, really good. Really good. So it's been quite inspiring. Very relaxed. So he really does the whole kind of calmness thing. Really good. So we just, this is called wobbling. So we're all breathing. Very nice. Keep breathing some more. So turn your right foot out. Now you've got these floorboards here. Look at the number of floorboards between your heels. Keep that same number of floorboards when you place your foot into right bow and arrow stance. So you want to use the floorboards as a way of getting your feet in the right place. That's it. And we're just, what we're going to do is we're just going to very gently sink through the front foot. We're going to transfer our weight sink through the back foot. We transfer the weight sink through the front foot. The clock was working last week, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh well. It's amazing how many times I haven't realised how useful that clock is. Well, it was. It's not at the moment.
It's probably an electric one.
What's a new battery?
What's a new battery, yeah.
Time travel slowly in
Spotify. Yeah, absolutely, yeah. So we're just transferring the weight. Transfer the weight. Okay, that was so good, we'll try that the other side. So bring that foot back. You stand in your Wu Chi first. Get yourself just so. And then heel toe. Check your feet. And then once you've checked your feet, then you get yourself nice and comfy first, and then we go forwards and back. Then what we're going to do, we'll do a few slower ones, and then we'll do some faster ones with the arm squeeze. So you want to let go in your shoulders, and just let the arms just gently swing forwards and back, not too far, not too far. So we're just doing that, and think about like you've got a trampoline. Imagine you're standing on a trampoline, doink, 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 and it's like a pendulum, the arms are like a pendulum. And you want to relax. Relax the shoulders and breathe. There we go. And then just swing. Swing, swing, swing. Very good. 4, 3, 2, 1. And now try that on the other side. Get yourself set up correctly first, and then you put your. Fantastic. 3, 2, 1. Okay. Let's just check. Okay, shoulders. So you come up, back, down, and round. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. 5, keep breathing. 6, check your posture. 7, 8, same shoulder, opposite direction. 1, 2. Other shoulder. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Other side direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Shake. Okay. Hands on the hips. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And the other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Nice, feet together, knees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Shake out. So very gently turn.
knees, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Semicircle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so the facing gong exercises, we'll just quickly go through those. So just you transfer the weight, breathe in, breathe out. So it's a deep relaxation exercises. And then raise the heel, down, raise the heel. So it's called balancing yin and yang. And again, you want to check your alignment, check your posture. Nice and relaxed. And then come up like this with the hand, breathe in. Come up, I'll do it from the diagonal view. Breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, and then with the transfer of the weight, so the fingers are forward, the thumb is forward. Forward, and it's a circle, it's called turning the wheel. So imagine a big wheel in front of you, and then raise the hip. Raise the hip. So this works your balance. Raise the hip. Show it on the side. Raise the hip. So we'll be looking at this for a little while, but it's not that long actually, just a few weeks. Great, okay. Circling the wrists, that's number 3. So they come in and then they come out. And you want to really relax the shoulders, relax all down the arms. We'll come a bit closer for the people on the Zoom. Now you come in, breathe out, that's it. Just nice and relaxed, in, forward. Transfer the weight. Come in, out. Into the middle, out to the side. Into the middle, out to the side. We'll just do that with a heel raise, a heel lift. That's it. So sink, raise the heel. Nice and tall through the head. You want to be nice and tall. Show you that from the side. So I'm lengthening along the spine. So it's called an upright spine. Lovely. One more time each side. That's good, everybody. Good effort. And then you come back. Okay, and then pressing the palms, so you go up to shoulder height and leg height, then you bring the hands back, turn the ball around, shoulder, leg. So you're just going to shoulder height, leg height, that's it, and then shoulder height, and leg height. And then what we do is you go to the lower hand, so the weight transfers to where the lower hand is. And then you come back. You go to the lower hand. Lower hand. That's it. Lower hand. Good. Yeah. Lower hand. Lower hand and raise the heel. So the heel goes up with a higher hand.
heel goes up higher. That's it. Back, turn, up, down, over, up and down. Up, down. Turn, transfer the weight. Up, down. Turn, transfer the weight. Last one of these, very nice. Okay, parting the weight. So you start like this, and you will just transfer the weight with this one. You transfer the weight, and then it's like a scissoring action with the arms, and then you come back, scissoring action with the arms. Bless you.
Excuse me.
Scissoring action with the arms. Okay.
We'll carry on until we. Yeah.
Ah, it's the T warning. Movement number 5. So I'd like to have a look at. Yeah, we'll definitely need to spend a bit more time on the Fasun Gong, I think, just because it's really good for coordination. And then we just raise the heels. There we go. One down, one up. So the hand goes down first. Think of the down hand and then the up hand. That's it. Down, up. Beautiful, look at that. Down and up. So it's just nice open feeling in the shoulder. Yeah. So I'll be being tested on this in a couple of weeks. So yeah, that's handy, isn't it? One more time each side. Very good. Fantastic. Okay, and then come back. And nice and relaxed. So, hang on. Parting away. Marching, that was it. Yeah. So this is the one where you reach for the T and stroke the cat. So just do that. So you have the hands come forward. So someone's handing you a cup of tea. So you want a nice round shape. You want to have the tiger's mouth shape. And then you turn your hand down and stroke down. Imagine you're stroking an animal of some sort. And then the other arm is relaxed. So you relax the arm that's not being moved. Okay, and then you transfer the weight and you just breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in. So think about how you're moving. That's it. Raise the heel. Keep breathing. So forward, you grab your cup of tea, stroke the cat. Grab your cup of tea, stroke the cat. This is what I made up, because it was the only way I could remember the hand shapes. Because I like tea and I like cats. So that's why I can remember it really well. And then it's much easier. Whereas if you just go, have your hand forward and then have your hand palm down, it's harder to, whereas if you grab your tea, stroke the cat, you know exactly what's going on. It's weird, isn't it? Human brains. Great. Okay, one more time each side. That's it. Yeah, that's better. That's better. Okay, and then the swinging arms. So you transfer the weight. Now, this is like a slow motion version. Imagine you've got a big cloak, big light but light cloak that you're swooshing around your body. Let me just show you that from the, there you go, and it's called swinging arms. It's like a slow down version of what we've done, and then raise the heel,
raised hill, and there's a little bit there. There we go.
Oh yeah, Apoth is fruit. I can remember all the moves, just not necessarily in the right order. So it's useful having the list. Marvellous. Okay, eight offers fruit. So we start that in the middle, and then we do the side to side, and then we do the hill rate, because this very sneakily works your hamstrings and your quads, and it helps develop the balance just by doing this exercise. It's great. So Apophis fruit. So imagine you've got, there we are, and then you turn the palms down, and then they come around in a curve. So it comes up pretty straight, and then it comes around in a curve. That's it, yeah, good. And we're breathing. And that was so good, we can start the weight shift. So you just shift the weight and you go to one corner. Then you can, as you come back to the middle, that's when you can bring the hands down, and then you transfer the weight to the other. So you want to be quite precise about where the weight transfer is happening. So this is one of the moves what I learned off of Mark Peters, who's the head honcho of the Tai Chi Union at the moment. He's very good, and he's developed this. He works with the physios and stuff at the Birmingham hospitals, and he developed this program so people can teach Tai Chi, and then raise the heel. There we go. And then we come down. We want to relax, soften, that's it. Relax the shoulders. One more time each side. Lovely. And we come back down. Okay, the next one's called shooting palms. It's quite easy. You physically touch the hand. I'll show you that from the... So one pulls back as the other goes forward. Just breathe naturally, and then you transfer your weight. You transfer your weight. Transfer your weight. So you're silk reeling on white apoth as fruit is the plan. And then with a heel lift. Yeah, it's a good set of exercises, this. Okay, I think I've decided to leave it for a bit, but actually I'm enjoying this so much, I think we should do it for the next couple of weeks, especially when I get back from Birmingham, because I've reviewed everything. One more time each side. That's wonderful, everyone. Really good. Okay, so, and then my favourite movement number 10, which is... pouring the energy from palm to palm, and I just love it. Imagine a big slinky spring or a rainbow. Imagine a beautiful rainbow that you've got between the palms of your hands, and then it comes over in a curve, and then it comes over in a curve, and then that comes over in a curve. And when we did this for ages with Mark, I could really feel like a kind of tingling in my hands and a real like, because it was really getting us to relax, really relax. And then you transfer the weight. So it.
Do you end up with a pot of gold?
I hope so. A pot of gold would be really welcome, wouldn't it, for a moment? But I don't know if that's. And we're all breathing, so we've got a few. This is a good one for the brain because you're having to keep your hands. So having to control the movement. That's it. Okay, and then one more time each side. Good effort, everyone. Very nice. Okay, now the penultimate movement is quite is unusual compared with all the others, because all the others would be doing this kind of stuff. This one, you go into bow and arrow stance, and we're staying bow. We're going to do 10. He normally does 20, but we, you know. And it's called Phoenix Rises from the Ashes. So you come down like that, and then you come up and rise from the ashes. And it's the only one of its type in this set of movements. So it's developed from a Chen stylist, and they're very nice. Show from the side. So like that, and then you open the chest, you use your legs, 8, 9, and up, fantastic, and 10, nice. Bring the feet back, nice and relaxed, place your other foot forward. And then we do it the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, nice, 5, 6. That's it. So this really does work your legs. So, you know, right at the end, they stick quite a tricky exercise that murders your legs. 8, 9, one more, 10. What a relief. Now, had I been Mark, I'd have made you do 20 each side. But 10 is quite a lot already, isn't it? I mean, if you're at home and you want to practice this in full, then go for it. Do 20, then really, you know, really work the legs. Really good. So the final move, movement number 12, which we all know, regulate the chi. There we go. Oh. At least I know it's regulated. What does he call it? Conclusion. It's called conclusion, but you're regulating the chi, so you kind of calm the mind, regulate the chi. And the breathing, you regulate the breathing as well. So that's all 12. So I've been working on this maybe 3 weeks, I think, 2 weeks, I can't remember. And relax. So just a little preview before we pause for a 10-minute tea break. 10-minute tea break, no more than that. We're going to be having a look at the silk reading, which is this. So we've got silk reading number 1, we've got silk reading number 2, we've got the combined silk reading, and then for fun, we're going to have a look at why take off as fruit. So we did this version, I think, without the stepping. So we'll have a look at it without the stepping, and then, which is like this, and we're using our whole body. So you're using your whole body together, and then we'll do the stepping version for fun. And it's very good for all sorts of things. It works your, you know, coordination, brain, legs, arms, tummy, everything. So we'll pause for tea. I'll get the chairs out.
Tea break. Right, I'll pause them.
Who's
fun?
So yeah, it's quite good actually. So just have your feet shoulder width apart, and we're just going to turn. We're going to loop a bit of sacks really.
Mike,
I don't know, I've not heard from them, so you know, it's they mysteriously vanished. You're not here next week, okay. And then we're not here the week after. But the other two will be back, and we're not here the week after. So remember everyone, no class on the 21st. Even those of you on Zoom, so but there will be a class on the 21st on Zoom in the evening. From my travel lodge, so it's a bit squashed. But I teach a form class, form and punching, we do on Monday evenings, and just what's been happening is because where I stay, they have Wi-Fi. It means I can carry on and do my class, but I just have the awkwardness of a tiny little hotel room. But it's all part of the. It's all part of the fun. So we're just, that's it. So you just want to, fantastic. Okay, so horse stance. Now you don't have to go into a huge horse stance. I'm going quite big so you can see what's going on, but just be wider than shoulder width. That's good enough because, you know. And then what we're going to do, we're just going to transfer the weight. So we'll look at a bit of the silk reeling. We'll look at some silk reeling. And then what I'd really like to do is spend a long time on white ape offers fruit. Because it's a useful precursor for when you're doing the... So you want to sink down. So you want to keep your hips and shoulders in line. And we're not... There we go. So yeah, you can... A lot of the classes are mixed... Whatever they call mixed media or mixed... Can't remember what they call it, but basically there's a few people that can't physically come to the class, so do it from their home in Zoom. And then I've also got some Zoom only classes on a Friday, and then my Burwell classes, there's no Zoom in them, that's just for the Burwell people. So
are your feet straight or pointed?
Yes.
Straight.
It depends on how your feet got put on. So some people like to be parallel, and mine are out slightly. But you've got to work out what works. It's not set in stone. It depends on how your feet and legs got put on. So some martial arts they do it like this with the feet. And when I did another martial art, they were very insistent on parallel. But in Chen style, they tend to be a little bit more flexible, which I quite like. So you transfer the weight and turn. Transfer and turn. Transfer. And then what we do is you put your hand on your dantian, and then we just... silk breathing. So it comes out, down, in and up. Now, Grandmaster Chen Xiaowang spent 7 minutes doing this one exercise. I'll just show you from the back. So it comes out at the top, comes in at the bottom, and you want really light hands, and the hands move with the moving of the waist and the weight. Turn around again. There we go. So you want to think about how you're moving and what you're sensing. And we're all nice and calm. So you want to calm down. So the Grandmaster does this stuff. There's like loads of videos of this bloke on YouTube. So there's... So you come like this. So it starts like this. So you want your right hand, I'm mirroring, right hand out. Turn the waist, drop.
bottom, turn the waist. Oh. So the silk breathing, that's like the functional unit of the Chen form. So when we actually get round to doing the Chen form, this is what's pretty much inside every move. The silk breathing exercise, that spiraling circular. Keep breathing. We're nice and relaxed. Nice and relaxed. Yeah, do be careful this time of year with the chests and coughs and colds, because now we're all out and about. It's not just the COVIDs and the flus now, it's all normal colds. Not had one of those for a while, because obviously I'm not hung out with anybody.
Fenrot.
Sorry?
Fenrot is what you get around here.
Fenrot, okay. Try that the other side, so with your left arm, so you put your hand here, so you can monitor in, you can monitor the turning of the dantian. You come down, you come in, you come up, you come out, and then you want to watch the alignment of the knees. So the knees stay in line with the toes, you're sinking your hips back and down, sink the hips, nice and relaxed. Very good, much better everybody. So he doesn't even go on to the second of the silk reading in his video. He spent ages doing that. Okay, and then this one goes 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're going to relax the shoulders. You're going to relax the shoulders, use the whole body. Feel that the whole of the body is connected. Keep breathing some more. Fantastic. Relax the shoulders, sink the hips. One more time. Swap round. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sneak the other hand in. So it's all mainly, you really soften the arms and lighten the arms. It's all the work is being done in the legs. It's being done in the legs. So same level, same level, same level. Up, shoulder height, both hands. Leg height, both hands. Shoulder height, both hands. Leg height. Other direction. So, chest height, bottom of the tummy height. Chest stroke, shoulder height, bottom of the tummy height. Turn, turn, open, turn. Bring the hands together.
2, 3. So doing movements like this, really, really good for developing your cognitive function. So it's quite exciting. Mike's just finished the videos for, he's taken part in, I think it's a 12-week study of Tai Chi, and they're going to be measuring things like your blood pressure, circulation, balance, bone density, all sorts. And they get enrolled on a program, so they do maybe a couple of classes a week, and then they have the video. So you turn open. Actually, I'll do it from the back view. Now you can see the arms. Now you can see the arms. So I'll turn to the left. I turn to the right. Back to the left. Turn to the right. Turn to the left. Let's have a look at white ape offers fruit. So what I'll do is I'll show facing, and then I'll turn round, and we'll all do it together with me facing the back. So then you've got, but you want to see what the arms are doing first. So what I'll just talk you through it. So demonstration, observe. You start holding the ball, you transfer your weight, part the wild horse's mane. Keep your weight in the front foot open. So you feel a stretch, release the stretch. This hand comes over, a bit like when we were doing this movement. So it comes over, the other hand goes towards it, stretch, hold the pearl, the dragon holds the pearl, sink, rotate. And then you do it the other side. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right, let's give that a go. I'll turn around. So we'll start facing. The right hand on top, left hand underneath. 1, transfer the weight and turn. Keep your weight in the left foot. 2, stretch. 3, bring the hands together. 4, sink back. 5, 6, and 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Very good. Okay, if everybody gets that end of the room, we're going to go for a walk. Very good. So I'm gonna change the video thing to that one. Let me just see. Oh, change the video. Let's see that. Oh, there we go. There we are. Right.
Right, so for fun, I will demonstrate. You go to cat's dogs, and you go one step, two cartwheels, which is moving, three open, four close, five sink back, six hold ball and sink back, seven. Simples, right? Just give it a bash for fun. So one step, heel toe, two transfer the weight, part of the last horse's mane. Now keep your weight in your front foot. Three, open, four, close. Five, sink back. Six, hold the ball, sink back, seven. One, two.
That's very clever, having two cameras, it's all very modern.
I'll just show you, so from the other direction. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Very simple. So that's quite useful. That's called Why Take Offers Fruit. It's from each one in tennis boxing. We've also got the. I'll just show you a quick section of what we're working on very slowly in this class, and also my Wednesday lunchtime class at Breach Village Hall. I'm also working at it there, and we've got a little bit further along in the form than here. So this is the first bit of the, so just watch. So go like that and step. So this isn't, I'm not mirroring those of you on Zoom, I'm just doing it how I'd normally do it. And then, so this is the first part. We'll go to the, where should we go to? Later, 16 and 4 closing, and then, yeah, we'll go into the first single whip. So that's the first section of the form. I think that's as far as we've got in reach. I think we've done it a couple of times, but actually, if you get used to doing Why Take Offers Fruit, in fact, we can do it as a step. So you can rather than we were doing it like this, not stepping and doing it one side to the other, you can actually do one that's not quite the same as walking forwards, but still has a step in. We'll do that as our grand finale. So go into, so mirror me, go into your left cat stance and then step out, part the wild horse's mane, open, close, stretch out, bring your hands to hold the pole, sink back and then bring the foot in. Now go into right cat stance. And then you step and part the wild horse's mane. So turn, stance, go to cat stance, bring it in, so cat stance, that's it. So you want most of your weight on that leg, and then you step to the diagonal, step to the diagonal. So you want to be on a rectangle rather than a tightrope. You want to be in a rectangle, and then you go like that. You turn. So the foot that's in front, that's your hand that's in front. Turn. Bring the hand in. Sink back. Sink forward. Hold the ball. Now bring your foot in. And we'll do one more. We'll do one more time. So your cat stance, and you point your knee and toe towards the corner. And then you step out. So you're in a nice wide start. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. There we go. Simple. So it's important when you're stepping that you give yourself a good chance for balancing. So you want to avoid tight ropes. So if you're stepping out, you want, so you can even do it using your tram lines. It's easier to balance when the feet are apart than when the feet are on the same line. Much harder to balance like that. Much easier to balance like that. So we're like this. Much easier to balance because I'm on my tram lines. You'll be on your tram lines when you're, and then you're not having to worry about falling because you've got a stable base. It's very important. Know where you're putting your feet. Don't just throw them out willy-nilly and hope. That's not going to work. Well, it might work. You might get lucky and you just so happen to have thrown your foot in the correct place. It's much more likely to happen if you place your foot in the correct spot and then you're balanced because you know, because it's in the right place. So very, yeah, that's where the paying attention to what you're doing thing is very, very useful. Very useful. Okay, let's, yeah. So, yeah, the arms tends to be the first thing people look at and worry about. And actually, that bit you should be ignoring completely. Look at the feet, look at the waist, look at the legs. Ignore what the arms are doing, because the arms are the after effect of all the other stuff underneath. So that's why they can be a bit of a distraction. I can't see what the arms are doing. No, doesn't matter. You want to see what the feet, you want to know where the feet are placed. And you want to develop your sense of awareness of where your feet are and what they're up to. Because we spend a lot of time in our heads and then this bit gets ignored. And you want to spend more time in your feet, I think. Yeah, the small grand people are very welcome. Embrace the tiger, return to the mountain. Bring them. Everyone likes. I'll try and remember to bring the hot chocolate. I did buy some specifically for, because I know smaller people like drinking chocolate, don't they? They tend to. But I keep leaving it at home. Embrace the tiger, return to the mountain. Okay, let's look super young today. So rub the hands together. Very good. And polish the base. And then rub the hands together again. Fantastic. And then give the lower back rub. Keep breathing. Very nice. Nice and relaxed, and then off we go. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. One more time.
just stand in your posture. Notice your breath. Notice the sensation of contact through the feet. Great. We'll make a fist with the right hand. Left hand over the top. Bring your feet together and bam. Well done, everybody. That was great. Well done. Well done, Zoomies. And see you all next week. Remember, the week after I'm in Birmingham. Okay.
Right.
Brilliant. Well done, everybody.
Good job. Okay. See you next time.